Moinsen, this is Sebastian. I just created an automatic photo trap for squirrels, using only a Sony Alpha and a Raspberry Pi. If you want to take a picture of an animal that is not as laid back with humans nearby, like these American squirrels I met in New York and Washington, you need a photo trap. When a skittish yet beautiful German squirrel started visiting us regularly, I realized that I only need two things for a fully automated photo trap: a computer with Wi-Fi, like a Raspberry Pi, and a Wi-Fi enabled Sony Alpha, so pretty much any Sony Alpha since the NEX 5R, in this case my old NEX 5T. The concept is simple: set up your Sony Alpha and start the remote control feature. Maybe use a dummy battery AC adapter if it should run the entire day. Then connect the camera's Wi-Fi with the Raspberry Pi, request the preview video stream to look for squirrels, and let it pull the trigger whenever a squirrel is in front of the lens. Since the Wi-Fi API for Sony cameras is properly documented and really just a simple HTTP REST API, the only tricky part is the squirrel detection. For this, I created a Python script using OpenCV. And if you now think that it uses gigabytes of squirrel pictures to train a squirrel recognition algorithm, you are overthinking the problem, like many people do today. No, it's much simpler. I use the fact that it is a proper camera and that I want a shallow depth of field anyways. So I open up the aperture wide enough to blur the background and set a manual focus onto the location where I try to attract the squirrels. Except for the nut box, most of the image is very blurry until a squirrel enters the frame. Now, if a squirrel enters in focus, most parts of the image turn crisp sharp. So all I need to do is analyze the sharpness, which we can do by looking at the standard deviation of a Laplace filter. I'm not here to give a math lecture in my free time, and neither are you. So it's enough to say that this can be done with only a few lines of code, and that this is a much simpler and faster method to determine if something interesting is in the frame, and not only for squirrels. The script averages this focus measure over a few minutes, and if it suddenly rises above a threshold, it triggers a picture. If you want to do this with your camera too, you can find the script and a few more details on my blog at There Ought To Be. You can either run the Python script on a laptop or PC with Wi-Fi that is connected to the camera, or you can use a Raspberry Pi. The only problem is that the camera needs to act as a hotspot, so your Pi cannot connect to your camera's Wi-Fi and your local Wi-Fi network at the same time. If you also want to access your Pi via Wi-Fi, you need to add a Wi-Fi stick and tell it to connect to two Wi-Fi infrastructures simultaneously, which can be tricky, and while I did this myself, it can be very hardware and distro specific, and I will not help you with this. But if you try to connect your Pi through a network cable, or just run it on its own and collect the images later, you can set up the connection to your camera with Raspi config, which should be very easy to do. Once your network is running, you can just start the Python script, wait until it has enough sample images to get a reference for the sharpness, and it should be ready to catch wildlife. In my case, I created the script one evening and we went out with the kids the other day. 10 minutes after we left, I caught a squirrel. Unfortunately, it did not show up again, and I am afraid that the rather loud shutter noise of the old NEX 5T scared it away. This is the only picture I got. Proof of concept. If you want more pictures, you might want to place the camera further away with a longer focal length, use a camera with an electronic shutter like many of the newer alphas have, or, well, use more courageous squirrels. Luckily, a few days later it came back for a real photo session. And with that, I'm out. Ciao.